Hey butterflies, what's going on? Ella here. Today's video is going to be all about episode 2 of Our Blindness Reality. Welcome or welcome back to the channel. Happy March, butterflies. Hope everybody's still staying safe and healthy. For episode 2 of Our Blindness Reality, I will be talking about the do's and don'ts when interacting with a blind or visually impaired person, while my OG Lighthouse Butterflies Squad will be sharing some of their experiences with those do's and don'ts. So let's get started. When speaking to a blind or visually impaired person, do speak directly to them and not to whoever they are with.
We were at a parent-teacher conference and the teacher says, oh, does he want to sit down? I thought, yeah, I'd like to sit down.
Do identify yourself, especially when they don't know who you are.
Yeah, I've definitely had, you know, people a couple times start talking to me and I'm just like, wait, who are you again? Or like all of a sudden, or like when you're in big conferences and big meetings and you don't know, you forget everybody's names and then say your name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just for the first couple times, you don't
do give clear or word picture descriptions and directions. Don't shout.
I had a guy, I was walking past the Smart and Final store, I'm coming up on where the carts are, and I hit a cart. Yeah, you guys know carts are just in random places.
Yeah.
So I'm walking along, and I bump a cart, and I realize, you know, I get it with my cane, and so I start to move around, and there's this guy who sounds kind of gruff. I don't know if he's a homeless guy or what, but he starts saying, you got to go to the right. So I kind of waved my hand, you know, my back was toward him. I kind of waved my left hand up, like, okay, thanks. And I'm moving and I'm feeling my way, you know, moving toward the right, getting around all the carts. And he's like, to the right, you got to go to the right.
Oh, that's happening.
Dude, settle down, man.
I remember one time I was walking with a friend. We were on an O&M lesson, the two of us. And I was walking, I was using my cane, and this guy was like, this actually happened several times, but this one in particular, it's like, watch out for the pole. And he's like, watch out. And I ended up running into it anyways, but the fact that he was so, he was just so like gruff and like, watch out. Like, oh, calm down. It's like,
don't be afraid to use visual vocabularies like look or see, and it actually offends us even more if you take those vocabulary terms out. When you see a blind or visually impaired person that seems to need assistance, do ask if they do need the help first.
You see a blind person out walking around, especially if they're by themselves with a cane or a dog, you should probably assume they have a pretty good idea of what they're doing. And don't try and do anything for them. You know, ask them.
Do provide the help if it is requested upon. Do respect the wishes of the blind BI person if they do decline your help. Don't touch or grab them out of nowhere.
It was touch. I'm like, don't touch me. Like, tell me you're there, where you're at or whatever. Like, if I'm veering or whatever, but don't touch. And don't touch the cane either.
Rule number one.
Yeah, never, do not touch cane.
Never, ever grab my cane.
When a blind or visually impaired person asks for direction, don't be indirect. Don't just point. And don't use words like right there, over there, right here, over here.
I mean, definitely it's great to have directions like it's going to be right in front of you, right to the left or right to the right, or, you know, two chairs to the right of you or something. So I think definitely explaining things in a geographic kind of description is really great for people who don't have sight or have low vision.
When I think people think that they blind people follow directions in like the same way, some people prefer the clock method and some people prefer, you know, different things. And so, yeah, it can be very complicated. Or sometimes when people are giving directions, they get their right and lefts confused. Yeah. So, you're right. No, you're left. I'm like,
now my Lighthouse Butterfly Squad will share some of their positive experiences when they have interacted with a sighted person.
I'm kind of banging into something and my cane's getting stuck. And this lady comes over, a very nice voice, nice, quiet. So, excuse me, sir. Would you like some help? She says, you're in the bike rack right now. I said, oh, okay. I was a little disoriented. She said, where are you trying to go? I said, I need to get over. I'm heading toward the Starbucks. Because there's a Starbucks on the other side of the Smart and Final. It's, you know, on the way back to my house. And she says, oh, okay, would you like me to guide you over there? I said, sure. Can I just grab your elbow? She said, sure. And we're walking along, and I'm still using my cane, and I'm tapping things. And she says, oh, that's the water dispenser. She says, okay, now we're coming up on the entrance to the Smart and Final. I said, okay. She says, watch out. They have some fire. Wow. Out there, so we're walking away. So, okay, this is the exit to the Smart Final. Great. So, you know, if you can just get me to the past the carts to that little walkway heading towards Starbucks, that'd be great.
Oh,
she's really nice. It was
wow.
Very. She had a very gentle voice, she says, "Okay, this is the." I could tell this the little walkway that I was looking for. And I said, "Well, thank you very much. I really appreciate your help."
Mm-hmm.
Well, have a nice day. You too.
That's so great.
Yeah, it was a very pleasant experience.
Yeah, I went to the post office a couple days ago, and so because there's long lines, the manager was doing crowd control. So I'm going to line up this way. I'm like, okay. So again, the back of the line looks fine. I can wait, you know. And then she came back to me because I think at first she didn't realize I had a cane because I like, you know, put my dog in his bag and like, get my cane ready, and then she's like, oh, do you need accommodation? I'm like, oh, okay, I guess. Like, you know, whatever. So she basically just kind of helped me bring me inside, and then I just went after the next person. So I think that's kind of what they're doing with COVID, is that they, you know, kind of afraid that you'll be not okay to wait in a line, or they're just going to help you kind of be inside, and then just you'll be the next person. So I think it's really great right now that they're doing that, because there's really long lines everywhere right now.
Yeah, but definitely. Yeah,
definitely the lines are very interesting to navigate.
But I remember one time I went to Chipotle with a couple friends, and there was this person that was so helpful. They told – firstly, they said, okay, I'm going to tell you – because you know how, like, we can navigate in a line because you just use your cane and you could feel the person in front of you. But, you know, if a person is generous enough to tell you, yes, I'll tell you when the line is moving. I usually like to ask, you know, and if they don't, that's okay. I'll use my cane. So this person was generous enough to not only say like, you know, hey, the line's moving, but they were generous enough to read like what's behind the glass, and they were very, very descriptive.
I had a similar experience at the Starbucks. So the very first time that I went out by myself with my cane, walked down to the Starbucks, and it was like a Saturday morning, mid morning, is pretty crowded, and I get inside, and you know, I've been to the Starbucks many, many times in the past, so I knew the layout. You know, what I could see, I'd been there many times. And so I go to the line, and I tap somebody, and I go, okay. And Elise says, oh, this is the end of the line here.
Oh,
okay. Thank you. And she says, I'll let you know when we move up. I said, oh, great. Thanks. And I tell her, this is my, my first, adventure on my own with this cane. And they were chatting for a little bit. And she says, you know, we're moving up, and she's telling me, and you know, we're chatting, and she goes up and orders. She's with a couple of friends, and they order. And then she says, okay, you can go up to the counter now. Yeah, this is all pre-COVID, obviously. You go up to the counter now. So I make my order. And then I ask the person behind the counter. I said, are there any open tables out there that I could sit at? And they said, yeah, there are a couple. And I was about to say, perhaps you could, perhaps you could take me to one of them.
Yeah.
And, but the lady says, oh, I'll take you to the same lady. She says, oh, I'll take you to to one of the tables. And she says, I'll let you know when your drink's ready. She knew my name. So I'll let you know. I'll bring you your drinks when they're ready. So, oh, thank you very much. So yeah, she took me to an open table and she brought me my drink, and it was really nice.
Lastly, do treat blind and visually impaired people like individuals. We are humans. Just because we're impaired doesn't mean we're less than. All right, butterflies, that is all for episode 2 of Our Blindness and Reality. Episode 3 will be coming out on the 28th of March, so check back in to watch that when it's posted. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you consider sharing this video, and I hope you also learned a little something from today's episode. I will see you on the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and always remember to be kind, spread love, positivity, and good vibes only. Bye, butterflies.